is our 40th poetry show. You know, it's the 40th anniversary of the school, and we've been doing poetry shows for 40 years. The poetry show is a signature program at Birchwood. By signature program, we mean in every subject, at every grade level, students have an opportunity to spend more time and more depth on in that subject so that they really get the time to go deep and to understand how does a historian think, how does a scientist think, and what are their skills, and what are their habits, and what are their abilities, and that takes time, and we immerse them. So when it comes to poetry, you know, we, of course, the historian, we understand the ideas and the skills that a historian needs, and we have History Day. And we have Science Fair, which over a long period of time, they do a project that where they have to apply the scientific method like scientists. But I thought since this might be the first poetry show for many of you, because these are younger children, I just wanted to take a minute to explain to you, why do we spend so much time on poetry in the classroom? And why do we call the poetry show a signature program? You have to think about, well, what is a poet? How do they think? How do they express themselves? A poet is a master of words. A poet knows how to take an idea and say it in the fewest amount of words with just the right word. And they are able to apply all their senses to capture a moment, an idea, just a human experience of family life or childhood, or beauty, or something profound that has come to them. They know how to express that using a certain language, poetic language, poetic devices, and figurative language. So we can't just do worksheets to learn poetic devices and have them have any of that feeling of a poet or have the language of a poet seep into their soul. So I thought I would just use a little example so you understand what I'm talking about and how hard these children have worked to get to the highest level that you will see. So you know the nursery, you may probably know the nursery rhyme, Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star, How I Wonder What You Are, Up Above the World So High, Like a Diamond in the Sky. So a poetic device, one of them is onomatopoeia, and that's when a word sounds just like what it means. So think of the word twinkle, 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 little star. But if you say it like this, twinkle, the word twinkles. And if you say twinkle twice, twinkle, twinkle, you're actually twinkling. It's really profound. It's so simple, but it's so beautiful. And then they learn, okay, the first line, twinkle, twinkle, little star. We don't let them say little star. It's little. Those are not D's in that word. It's little. And just think about it. The word little has charm. But if you say little star, it's just a sentence, but it doesn't bring out each word and what the poet understood that they were doing with that word. So it sparkles like a diamond. That's a simile. I don't know if a first grader could define a simile for you, right? But they are getting similes and metaphors into their soul, the language, and also the beautiful ideas of beauty and truth in human life. So they've had to memorize, which in itself is jaw-dropping, but they have had to learn line by line, word by word, how to say it, pronounce it, express it the way the poet intended. So they learn pace, they learn volume, they learn articulation, they learn expression, and not just vocal expression, facial expression, body expression, and then how to work as a team to carry out all the formations. So I could probably go on and on, I better stop, but I want you to appreciate all the hard work that has gone on here and what the teachers have accomplished. They are amazing. So that's it. We'll let the kids take it from here.
Friends, family, and faculty, welcome to the 1st-4th grade poetry show.
Before we can begin, there are a few cardinal rules that must be ruled. Sorry, cardinal rules that must be read. Please, no recording of any kind. We are recording the show to share with you all. It is very
striking.
I'm sorry, what?
I have a joke.
Right now.
Okay, fine. Bling, bling.
Hello? Who's there?
Orange.
Orange who?
Orange, you glad we didn't tell you to silence your cell phones?
But honestly, everyone should probably silence their cell phones.
Please don't talk about our show. We worked really hard and are excited to show it to you.
Besides, we wouldn't want our teachers to have to yellow at you. I mean, yell at you. Like they do to the chatty students in class.
One more thing. You might have brought a little sibling, and we understand that they might get a little fussy.
But when their face is turning violet and their screams are sounding violent, please feel free to take them outside your apron.
Class will indigo into detail about all the colors in a child's day.
Then the second grade class will share poems all about colorful animals that can be green, sorry, seen on a spinning carousel.
Next, the third graders will present the seasons in every wonderful blue.
You mean hue?
Right, the seasons in every wonderful hue.
Finally, the fourth grade program shows all the colors that purple feel throughout life. Didn't you mean people feel?
Oh yes, the feelings that people feel throughout life.
We present to you
a kaleidoscope of words and colors. Enjoy the show!
Circles, you're my kaleidoscope. I love every minute, you've got me in it. You're my kaleidoscope. And purples, diamonds, and circles. You're my kaleidoscope. I love every minute. You've got me in it. You're my kaleidoscope. Living all of my days the same. Then you came along and you sang your song, and the whole world around me changed. Violets and purples, diamonds and circles, you're my kaleidoscope. I love every minute, you've got me in it. You're my kaleidoscope.
He's already 86.
Dragon Smoke by Lillian Moore.
Breathe and blow white clouds with every puff.
It's cold today, cold enough to see your breath.
Huff. Breathe dragon smoke today.
Hide and Seek Shadow by Margaret Hiller.
I walked with my shadow.
I ran with my shadow.
I danced with my shadow, I did.
Then the clouds came over.
And the sun went under.
And my shadow sat and hid.
Paper.
spectrum of colored poems by focusing on carousel animals. What do carousel animals have to do with kaleidoscopes, you may ask? A kaleidoscope is continually changing color of patterns and shapes. A carousel or a merry-go-round does the same thing. Mesmerizing its waiting riders like a kaleidoscope, mesmerizing its viewers. I present to you the second grade class.
And silver, a royal coat of brushed and beaten gold.
Tiger by Amy Gibson. His roar could shake the forest floor, but tiger opens not his jaws. He steals on silent padded paws and leaves the talking to his claws.
Tiger by Mary Ann Hoberman. I'm a tiger striped with fur. Don't come near or I might grr. Don't come near or I might growl. Don't come near or I might bite.
Seal by William J. Smith.
See how he died from the rocks at the zoo, through the watery room, kept past crabs and eels and green seaweed, past lots of sandy minnow feet.
See how he swims with a swerve and a twist, a flip of the flipper, a flick of the wrist. Quick, silver, quick, softer than string, down he plunges and sweeps away.
Before you can think, before you can utter words like dill pickle or apple butter, back up he swims, past stingray and shark, out with a zoom, a whoop, a bark.
Before you can say whatever you wish, he plops at your side with a melon.
say, winter's a song. But bears don't sing, they just plod along. Polar Bear by Gil Spencer. The secret of the polar bear is that he wears long underwear.
White feathers. Who flies over white owls? for a fantastical spin.
How Duck the Little Crocodile by Lewis Carroll.
How Duck the Little Crocodile improved his shiny tail and poured the waters of Nile on every golden scale.
How cheerfully he seems to grin, how neatly spreads his claws, and welcomes the fishes and they gently smiling jaws.
Pleasant. Don't
December brings us meat,
blazing fire, and Christmas treats.
Autumn is the dashing red squirrel, the ripe orange pumpkin, and the gold of falling leaves.
Celebrate the season of fall with these first four poems.
World.
This winter,
Her nose went sniff. Her shoes went squish.
Her socks grew soggy.
Her glasses got foggy.
Her pockets filled with water and a little green froggy. I thought you were the garden!
jumps and it's starting to drip all over my fingers, my chin, and my lip.
My ice cream is melting. I can't make it stop. It's hitting the ground with a splash and a flop.
My ice cream has melted and turned into ooze. It was on a cone, but it's now on my shoe.
Sand by John Foster.
This is how you see.
And yet, they're so important.
In my pictures about me.
My joy is cheery yellow.
Like a happy, smiley face.
Like daffodils and sunbeams.
Or a trophy from a race.
My anger is bright red.
An untamable beast.
Volcanoes erupting.
And wildfires unleashed.
My sadness is the deep blue of burning tears upon my cheek.
Lonesome and lost in the rain, feeling tired and so weak.
My jealousy is evergreen, never losing its sharp leaves.
Like a snake upon your shoulder, a yarn of lies it weaves.
My fear is a vivid purple of spiders, clowns, and greed.
Of darkness and thunderstorms.
A flower stifled by a weed.
So how do I paint feeling?
Not in pigments or in shale,
but with my words and stories.
And everything that's true.
Our first and favorite feeling is happy.
Who doesn't love to be happy?
These three poems celebrate the feeling that puts a smile on our faces.
We think you will enjoy them too.
Smile in Your Pocket by Josie Carey.
There's a smile in your pocket.
There's a smile in your sleeve.
There's a smile in your pocket and it isn't make believe.
There's a smile in your pocket.
There's a smile in your shoe.
There's a smile in your pocket without anything to do.
Now, a pocket is handy for candy and dandy for string.
A pocket is nifty for folks who are thrifty with rubbers and rings.
All sorts of things.
But a smile in your pocket feels a bit out of place.
There's a smile in your pocket.
Wants to be on your face.
The Land of Happy by Shel Silverstein.
Have you been to the Land of Happy where everyone's happy all day?
Where they joke and they sing of the happiest things. And everyone's jolly and gay.
There's no one unhappy and happy.
There's laughter and smiles galore.
I have been to the Land of Happy.
What a bowl.
Feel angry.
but we have to work through those feelings too.
The Bad Mood Bug by Rod Babbert. I don't know what I want today, but nothing feels quite right.
If I had an ice cream pie, I wouldn't take a bite.
I wouldn't ride a water slide, climb monkey bars or trees.
No games, no toys, no magic wands, no elephants for me.
There's a grouchy bug inside me. It's usually asleep.
But when the grumpy thing
wakes up,
I turn into a creep.
Belinda Blue by Jack Krilutsky.
Belinda Blue was furious. She fumed.
I'm really mad. This is the worst experience that I have ever had.
She beat her fist against the wall. She pounded on the floor.
I'm livid.
She exploded.
I'm furious to the core.
She wrung her hands. She tore her hair. Her tantrum grew and grew.
I'm angry, angry, angry!
Freaked and raged Belinda Blue.
She seemed to be beside herself. She raced around the room. She roared so loud the neighbors thought they'd heard a sonic boom.
Ah!
Her rage was unabated. It appeared she'd never quit. In fact, she seemed to savor every second of her victory.
Belinda Blue created such an overwhelming scene because at lunch her mother said,
"Please eat just one green bean."
Rotten Mood by Jack Proletsky.
I'm in a rotten mood today. A really rotten mood today.
I'm feeling cross.
I'm feeling mean.
I'm jumpy as a jumping bee.
I have an awful attitude.
I'm in a rotten mood.
I'm in a rotten mood today.
A really rotten mood today.
I'm in a snap.
I'm in a stew. There's nothing that I care to do but sit all by myself and brew.
I'm in a rotten mood.
I'm in a rotten mood today.
A really rotten mood today.
You better stay away from me. I'm just a lump of misery.
I'm feeling absolutely rude.
I'm in a rotten mood.
What do you do with the mad that you feel? By Fred Rogers.
What do you do with the mad that you feel? When you feel so mad you could bite.
When the whole wide world seems oh so wrong, and nothing you do seems very right.
What do you do? Do you punch a bag?
Do you pound some clay or some dough?
Do you round up friends for a game of tag? Or see how fast you go?
It's great to be able to stop when you plan the thing that's wrong.
And be able to do something else instead. And think this song.
I can stop when I want to. Stop when I wish. I can stop, stop, stop anytime.
And what a good feeling to feel like this. And know that the feeling is really mine.
Know that there's something deep inside
that helps us become what we can.
For a girl can be someday a woman.
And a boy can be someday a man.
Unfortunately, there are a lot of bad emotions. Mad isn't the only one.
Sometimes we feel frustrated. Sometimes we feel sad. Sometimes we feel jealous of some things we wish we had.
These next three poems will touch on the depths of these feelings.
Shivvy
by Michael Rosen.
Grown-ups say things like,
"Speak up!
Don't talk with your mouth full!
Don't stare!
patch of sky that sometimes hangs blue and sometimes hangs gray over the fields where I used to play.
Goodbye to my old friends, Jason and Sue. They wave from their porches. Are they crying too?
The moving truck rumbles past all that I know. The school, in the woods, in the creek down below. And everything seems to be pleading.
Go!
Life's Not Been the Same in My Family by Jack Prelutsky.
Life's not been the same in my family since the day that the new baby came. My parents completely ignore me. They scarcely remember my name.
The baby gets all the attention.
Oh, isn't she precious?
They think she looks like an angel. I think she resembles a plume.
They're thrilled when she giggles and gurgles.
She pooped.
They exclaim with delight. They don't even mind when she wakes us with deafening screams in the night.
They seem to believe she's a treasure. There's simply no way I agree. I wish she'd stop being a baby and start being older than me.
Fear is an important emotion. You feel it when you're not safe. You feel it when you try something new. You feel it when you don't understand or when something's hard for you.
Our first scared poem was written by a fifth grader who later went on to become famous for her songwriting.
She submitted it to the Creative Communications Poetry Contest, the same one we enter every year, and it was chosen as a top 10 poem that year. It explores the fear we feel for mysterious creatures lurking in the dark, empty spaces in our house.
The second one discusses how much bravery it takes to admit that you were wrong and apologize for your mistakes.
Our first poem is A Monster in My Closet by Taylor Allison Swift.
There's a monster in my closet and I don't know what to do.
Have you ever seen him?
Has he ever pounced on you?
I wonder what he looks like.
Is he purple with red eyes?
I wonder what he likes to eat.
What about his size?
Tonight, I'm gonna catch him. I'll set a real big trap.
And then I'll train him really well. He'll answer when I clap.
When I looked up in that closet, there was nothing there but stuff.
I know the monster's in there. I heard him huff and puff.
Could it be he wants to eat me?
Maybe I'm his favorite prey.
And if he comes to get me, I'll scream loudly, go away. If he's nice, I'll name him Happy. If he's bad, I'll name him Grouch. I suspect that he is leaving, but if not,
we'll kick him out!
Apology by Judas Voice.
It's hard to say I'm sorry, although I'm feeling sorry.
The s always sticks in my throat, and I made a big mistake. Would produce a bellyache that might last till I was old enough to vote.
Please forgive me. Sounds real good. And I'd say it if I could.
But between the forgive and the please, I'd have to go to bed. With a pounding in my head and a very shaky feeling in my knees.
I was wrong. It seems oh so light, but it gives me such a flight that my one always turns to eight. So I hope you'll take this rhyme as my way of saying
been quite the emotional roller coaster. But we have one last poem.
We can't shy away from life out of fear. We want you to know that we are not afraid.
To prove it, we present Life Doesn't Frighten Me at All by Maya Angelou.
Shadows on the wall?
Noises down the hall?
Life doesn't frighten me at all.
Bad dogs barking loud?
Big ghosts in a cloud?
Life doesn't frighten me at all.
Mean old mother goose.
Lions on the loose?
They don't frighten me at all.
Dragons breathing flame
on my counterpane?
They don't frighten me at all.
I go boo!
Make them shoo!
I make fun way they want.
I won't cry, so they fly.
I just smile.
They go wild.
Life doesn't frighten me at all.
Tough guys in a fight,
all alone at night.
Life doesn't frighten me at all.
Panthers in the park,
strangers in the dark.
No, they don't frighten me at all.
That new classroom where boys pull my hair.
You see little girls with their hair in curls.
They don't frighten me at all.
Don't show me frogs and snakes and listen for my scream.
If I'm afraid at all, it's only in my dreams.
I've got a magic charm that I keep up my sleeve.
I can walk the ocean floor and never have to breathe.
Life doesn't frighten me at all.
Not at all. Not at all.
Life doesn't frighten me at all.
Kaleidoscope.